Greetings everybody, welcome back to another episode of Serious Keeper's Adventures in Serious Remnants. Still using that texture pack from last time I tried out, and I think I'm going to use it for the rest of the episode and then kind of decide if I want to keep it or not. But again, sorry for the lack of episodes, I'm still... You're too restless. Oh yeah! I forgot I did that. I'm still working on these quests and some other things as well, so there's like... A little bit of delay always in between episodes because I need to like, work out stuff and get things done, and still a little bit slacking on the quests themselves. However, I did some changes. I actually added a bunch of mods to this pack, and I'm still like kind of trying to figure out how I want to set it all up and stuff. One thing you might see here, we can no longer sleep. I added no doze from Walrat, the mod that lets you, that prevents sleeping, but it still sets your spawn point, so you don't have to worry about that. Although I don't know if this is his mod right now. There might be a conflict right now, because I did try to use a different mod before, their mod here. Do I still have that on? No sleep, no, okay. So that's probably from his mod. You rest too restless to sleep. Hopefully that sets the spawn point. It should. So that's that. So I talked about that, I think, in an update video where I said that I actually like it when you can't really sleep in a game. But if you don't like it, you can always just disable that mod, I guess, and you can sleep again. You can see all these items, crazy item physics. I was messing around with this, the item physics mod. There's a mode where you have to like right-click items to pick them up. I think that's a little bit tedious, although at the same time I'm kind of curious to see if I would enjoy it if I like use it for a while, but it's just some visual stuff right now. Items just falling onto the ground rather than like floating, but I might not keep this. This might go away. So yeah, right now it's nighttime, and that's why I did it, because like nighttime's always seemed so like easy if you can just sleep it away, right? But now we can't sleep it away. Now we have to kind of, you know, survive the night as well and kind of plan out our day a bit better to see what we want to do at night and stuff. On top of that, this is something I added to my mod, to my Serious Edition mod, and that was a lot of fun to try out. I was messing around with the idea of water. Do I have another bucket by any chance? Don't really want to make a new one. Okay, let's just break this here. Put the water in here. If I try to pick this water up, this is an infinite water source, right? Nope, not anymore. So I made it so that water is finite. You can't create infinite water springs anymore. And on top of that, bottles also consume source blocks now. Same as the canteen. So this was a little big change that I was thinking about doing, and I wasn't sure at first if I wanted to do this, but I think this is going to be pretty neat in the long run. The thing about drinking river water the whole time is that there's no downside to this, right? Like, you get that little green debuff, but it doesn't really affect you in any negative way, really. Yeah, you can just keep drinking it, and it doesn't, you know, it doesn't really affect you. However, if the water is finite, you may want to think about using better ways of getting water. We have the rain collector, you know, which also, now that we can't sleep, the chances of rain is going to be higher. So you can use that. And one thing we should make right away, actually, that would help us with this, is to make the good old vanilla cauldron. Because this one, if you use it, let's put it over here. If you put water into this one, a bucket of water, you actually get 3 bottles worth out of it. If you just use a normal bottle on the source block, you consume the entire source block. But if you use it on a cauldron, you get 3 bottles out of it. So if I drink this one, and I take this, see? Still have 3, or 2 more left. So that's a good way of doing that. And I did the same with the canteen. I had to, like, do some weird overriding of their functionality and stuff. That was interesting, because I never really have done that. Just from, like, a modding point of view. So that's a big change. Also, I added this mod, Attaint Drops. This is sort of like, sort of like magical crops, where you can grow certain mob drops, right? You need these life essences, which you get by killing mobs, And then out of them, you can make these drop plants. And then with some eggs and dirt, you make these vitalized soil planters. They vitalize dirt around them in a one, I think it's only one range. Yeah, just the adjacent blocks, I think. And then those fertilized blocks can be, I think you right-click these guys on there. Right-click on an enriched, yeah, vitalized block to start the plant growth. And then you put in the item you want to grow, like a bone or a zombie flesh or whatever you want. And I also disabled that you can use bone meal on them, so you have to just wait for them to grow. Just a little bit of a balance, but I think that's a nice way of getting some extra mob drops as well, because we don't really have like crazy mob farms in here or anything like this, right? So maybe that might be a good thing. But yeah, I want to make a backpack. I've been wanting to make one, so that's just any kind of wool, gold, and leather, so that's not too bad. I should have this limestone. Getting used to texture packs. Always fun, there's some wool. I haven't heard like much negative stuff about the texture pack, so I'm hoping that you guys are enjoying it or liking it. Alright, so we can put this down, right click to open it, and I could put in a bed, for example, and then I think you shift, wait, you can't equip back, oh, right. If you shift break it, you put it on your back. You can even see it at the back there. Cute. Ideally, I would like to use the iron backpack mods, but it's not out yet for 1.11, last time I checked, so can't really use that, can we? Do I want to use coal? Yeah, let's use coal. Let's make some of these. Sure, why not? Cool. So today, I want to go to that swamp island again and see if we can find a slime. I have a bucket. We can actually pick up slimes in the bucket. And then we get an item that lets us see if we're in a slime chunk or not. It's almost daytime, so we should be able to go soon. I'm just gonna go organize a bit, and then we go and explore. Oh, we also got another mod in here. Just another crafting bench. Awesome. This one is like a crafting bench, but if you close the inventory, items stay inside. Ah, I was waiting for this. Stupid witches. Hate them. Alright, she's dead too. Right, this is the swamp, so hopefully we can find some slimes here. I forgot if the bat do anything in this. Like, when she dies, she spawns bat. I think we have... There are these, like, vampire bats. I think I have them enabled. Not entirely sure, though. Let's get rid of this stuff. Hi, cows. I should really start collecting animals. Although, like I said, I do kind of want to move somewhere else. I don't want to build or stay where we are right now. And over here, this is actually from Roots, too, as well. At night, you will see some moonlight shining down onto these. And this is how you craft some of the first things with Roots. But I will do that in a bit. Now, hopefully, if I remember correctly, slimes do spawn in swamps, right? In swamp chunks or swamp biomes. No matter of the Y level, I think. I don't remember if they spawn during the day as well. Or if it's still only at nighttime. But I may try to find a cave or something. There's a big mushroom. That's just some ambient sounds. Should probably disable that one. It's a little bit spooky. Is that ice? Or marble, probably. Yeah. Maybe it's better to just dig down and see if I can find a cave here. This is swamp, right? Yeah, swampland. Okay. Lots of cows, at least. Oh, hello. I found something. And I believe this is one of my structures, actually. I think this is the little dwarven rune I added at one point. Interesting. I always tried to find this when I, like, added it, and I could never find it. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's mine. It spawns funny. I need to fix that. Oh, yeah. Awesome. Good. There's also, like, a dwarven rune that's added by Embers itself, but this one here is like one I made. I don't want to like break it completely though. There's an entrance here. Let's maybe use that. All right. Yeah. Oh yeah. Physics. Item physics. It does that. Crazy stuff. There's embers in here, but because of their mod, they go a little bit crazy. But yeah, this is the one I added. I just added like a bunch of pipes here and stuff, and this is a way of getting some embers through world gen, I guess. If we drop some of these things that we don't really need these calamite things. I forgot how you do it. This is empty hand. Yeah, there's 5 shards in there. 25 in here, or 20 in total. It's 25, and then these archaic blocks. You can't really do much with them except for like, you know, decorative stuff. So like you get some crazy good stuff out of here. This, however, is a cool light. You could steal that one, I guess, and take it with us. Nice, because these are a little bit. It's just 4 of these blocks, which you have to craft later, but was an ember shard. It's not super crazy either, but, you know. Nice to have anyway. Oops, I have that stupid thing on. Well, it is nighttime by now, so maybe it's the easiest to try to find some slimes out here. Oh boy. Sure wish I could see more right now. Maybe quickly make a bunch more torches. Alright. Oh, there comes the creeper squad right behind me. And zombies. I just need one slime. Oh crap. I think this is a terrible idea. I think I already regret coming here at night. Maybe, oh, you know what, actually, whoa, okay, this is bad, go down, oh no, crap, damn it, ah, hate him, maybe it's better to get there at night, and then just wait for everything to burn up, and then slime should still stick around, right? Maybe I should do that. Oh man, now I need to go back somehow. Who made this pack so difficult? What a jerk. Oh, there's no way I can get back like this. Oh man. Azok, who's this? I'm like a special dude. I don't even know where he's from, to be honest. I see you, that creeper. Wow, he has health. Oh, sneak attack for twice the damage. Oh, that's cool. I didn't know that either. Holding shift, apparently. Dude, he doesn't die at all. Now he runs away. What a jerk. Dude, this guy just doesn't die. Oh, no. How did you get in here? Oh, did he spawn them or something? It's getting a little bit crazy in here. Yeah, you guys burn. Does this guy really not die? Wow, finally! I wonder if he dropped anything good then. Okay. I don't know where the creeper went. I know there was one here. I don't think I killed. Ooh, he dropped pants though. Diamond leggings. Feather falling too, interesting. Nice, okay. Back to the shack, I guess. To the witchy shack. I did see when I was running over here. Oh, I forgot to start my timer again. There was an embers enemy as well, an ancient golem. We need to kill these because it drops something that we need for getting started with embers as well. But I guess they despawn during the day, maybe? So they're probably not around anymore. Hey, skeleton horse. Oh, is this my old stuff? Yeah, old stuff. Makes it really hard to see with this item physics mod. I'm still not sure if I want to use it or not. It's just like, you know, something to try out for a while. Same with like the sleeping. I'm kind of regretting it almost now, not being able to sleep. This was brutal. You know what's actually smarter to do probably is just wait in that house till nighttime, so mobs spawn in the swamp, and then wait till daytime while I'm safe inside that witch house, and then during the day just go and clean up the place and see if any of the slime spawned. But hopefully I'm gonna go get my stuff back. It should be okay because these chunks weren't loaded, I think. So I should get my stuff back at least. I hope so. We had a cool sword and everything. Yeah, that over there. I'm using Journey Map. I would love to use Antique Atlas, but it's also not out for 1.11. There is a 1.11 branch and it seems to work. Like, I compiled it myself and I checked it out. But, you know, it's like, I can't include it in the pack then. Oh, that's my backpack. Okay, so the backpack places itself. Ooh, that's cool. Didn't know that. That's really good to know. Alright, I'm gonna go collect my stuff, hopefully all of it, and then I'll be back soon. Ugh. Listen to this mud sound. It's just gross. Oh, man. Hello? No one here? Good. Yeah, I even decorated it. Looks kind of funky, though. Cool. Oh, there's a cauldron, too. Which is good, because I can use it to drink. Right. Oh, yeah. One thing I forgot to show is I removed player stats, too. But I replaced it with level up. So we can actually choose what kind of class we want to be, or we can be a freelancer. And depending on that, you get like skill points that you can distribute among like certain skills. If you pick a class other than freelancer, though, you get like extra XP from specific specializations. I guess the freelancer doesn't do that. So I don't know if I want to be a miner, maybe? Mining, digging, and smelting. Scout is marksman. That's kind of cool. Defense might be actually pretty good. Spelunka, defense, athletics, and mining. I think athletics is probably speed, I'm guessing. Digging, mining, woodcutting. This one is really good for like all, you know, all around person, I guess. Stealth, woodcutting. I think I kind of want to go defense. I think spelunka is pretty good. Mining is nice. We get extra XP from mining. We get defense and some movement speed. So I think I'm going to use that. And then if we open that menu again, we have some points left. I don't know how many right now. But we can assign them to other things as well. So mining, for example, plus one. Or every one increases chance of 2x ore drops, which is super cool. And every 5 increases the speed, the mining speed. Defense, chance, super block, damage from mob reduced. So this is really good, actually. Defense is because I keep dying a lot, so maybe I'll put 5 more into here, 5 more into this. Athletics, sprint speed, and falling damage reduced. And of course, we can still put them into other things, right? This is cool too. If you smell things, you have a chance to get twice the stuff out of it. Maybe I'll put 1 in there just so there is a tiny bit of a chance to do it, I guess. You know, I'm just going around killing all these cows here to get some leather. To maybe make a canteen, but because you know, I won't live here anyway, so it doesn't matter if they're here or not. Oh shoot, I'm burning, I'm gonna die again. God damn it, man, please cool me down. But I was just thinking, one mod that might be kind of cool, like a small one, is something like if you use a sword on cows, they give you maybe more. Leather, and if you use an axe, they give you more meat instead or something like that. So you can kind of like decide what kind of drop you want to get from them. I think that might be kind of neat. Might actually look into that if I want to do something like that. Similar to like Ark Survival, I think, does that, right? Where depending on the tool, you get like either one more of this or one more of the other. So, because sometimes leather is a little bit rare, I feel like. Alright, yeah, I have enough to make a canteen now while I'm waiting here at night in that little house. There we go. Let's actually drink our water first. And the canteen should work the same as the bottle on like things. It should also like drain Damn. I also added a little bloop 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 sound to it. Not necessary for anything, but I thought it might be kind of fun. And this one gives you 4 uses, right? No, 3 uses. So that in itself, if you use this in combination with a cauldron, you get 9 uses out of 1 bucket of water. So that's kind of like how you can manage your water a little bit better, I guess. Oh, and I should mention later on, that's why I haven't released this yet either, because I need to remove the recipe for this. You can get a pump that can pump liquid out of it, but I'll put this behind like a quest reward or something and make it not craftable, I think. All right, let's see if there's any slimes over there. I really, really, really hope so. Nope, no slime. Oh, hey, I was just like swimming around to see if I find any more swamps or something, but there is a village here very close. Oh, wait, this is a starter village? No, this is a new one, I think. Oh, look at this. Nice port for us to dock. Haha. That's pretty cool. Let's go check this out. Yeah, so, but if you look at, here, let's go to Toughest Nate. The whole point of getting slime is to make this slime armor, right? So we could get it with raw jellyfish, but I don't know if you get this other than killing the guardians. I think you can make a fish trap. We could try that and see if you can get one of them as well. Or if you can make a block of slime, we can turn it into 9, right? And we can make slime blocks out of glue, but each glue needs 1 piece of leather, so... that's a little bit expensive, but I guess it's only 9 pieces. So if you have 9 pieces of leather, which I don't think I have right now, we could do that as well. But yeah, let's check out if there's anything good in this village. Ooh, there's a blacksmith. The best building in this town. Ooh, we got another weapon case, second edition. Some gold, some iron boots. Okay, I'll take all of this. Sweet, we'll crack that open at the end of the episode, maybe. God, I love these doors. And up here, we have a bunch of weapons again. I like all these arrows. I'm gonna take them. I don't think I need the leather stuff this time. Oh man, look how this mossy stone on the ground looks like. That looks so nice, actually. That's really cool. Ooh. Could mine out all of the stuff. And, oh wow, lots of iron armor. Yes, please. More gold, a saddle. Can we craft these in here? Yes, we can. So I'll actually leave this here. But all of this other stuff is good. Look how cute this looks. Ah, I love it. The texture pack. I love it so much. Ooh, found a chest. One of mine. Kind of freaked out right now, though, because there are mobs around here. Okay, we have gold. Oh, ender pearls. Bottle of enchanting. Food. And a new shield. Okay, can take it all. Alright, we are back home. Sweet. Oh, I forgot we need a stone crucible to turn this into glue. And we can't get the stone crucible quite yet. Actually, no. I think we can work towards that. Yeah. So I don't think we can really do much about the cold right now. Unless I find some slime somewhere. But let's open this one here. See what kind of sword we get this time. A saber. 7 damage, 1.6 speed. Same as this one. And it doesn't have a lot of durability, I don't think. Put it in here. Why not? Alright. Well, so let's look at this. To get the stone crucible, we do need the hibachi grill. We can get the heating element, right? Redstone blaze powder. Ew. I don't think I have blaze powder yet. And going to the nether would be terrible. Ah, no. I don't think we can do this then. Do we get any blaze by any chance? Probably not. No, I don't think there's any way to get blaze powder otherwise. It's not in the loot chest or anything. Huh. I feel like I really need something to cool me down. Because I need to go to the nether. I need to find blazes. And I need to find more netherrack and soul sand. And I'm probably going to burn up as soon as I enter the nether, right? Oops. See how long we can last in here before dying completely. Let's grab some of the glowstone, maybe. Maybe grab a little bit of this too. So far, the temperature isn't going up much. Temperature's rising. Temperature's rising. We're going to die I might just have to dig down. Dig a huge open room. Oh, it resets your temperature. That's weird. And hope that we can find some blaze. Some slime. Wait. We still have options here. We still can get it through that jellyfish, right? Two things I could think about here. First of all, let's make the fish trap, which is just fishing rod, sticks, string, and a chest. There we go. But then we also need this fish bait. Oh, dude, you scared me. Suddenly zombie pigman down here. I should really block off that portal down there. we need the fish bait, so we need any three fish. Although we could try something else. We could make the market. This one lets you buy certain items from Palm. So I wonder if we can buy... What's this? Bone meal. No, there's no like fish stuff in there. Okay. Can we fish in this little thing here? Oh, maybe. There we go. Fish trap bait. Now I need to place this in the water somewhere, but it is night right now, so I'm gonna just keep fishing for a while. Oh, there's an ember guy. I don't know, remember if you have to kill him with a pickaxe now. I don't think you have to do that anymore. You used to, but I don't think you do now. Okay, he died. So you should drop some archaic blocks. Yeah, and this guy, the motive core. Cool. And with those two items, we can craft the kind of the manual for this mod. Alright, but I'm gonna set up my fishing thing here real quick. Wow, what's up with all these mobs suddenly? Alright, I'll let this run for a while. Ha, here we go, the ancient codex, that's how you make it. And that one, if you open it, tells you a lot about all the Ember stuff. Of course, we can't start yet until we get the anvil from BetterWithMods, but we have this thing already, awesome. I made like a little secret tunnel to our fishing trap, but it just occurred to me, I don't even know if the one we need would spawn in here, and if so, it might take quite a while. I got like two fish here before, so I took them out. Now we have two other ones in here, but yeah, this might actually be a really, really long process. Is there a way to craft these guys? No. Alright guys, it is actually the next day for me now, and I was thinking about the whole slime situation, and I decided to add a recipe for slime. Balls, I should say. So if you look this up and we look for the recipe, I added a cauldron recipe which requires flour from BetterWithMods, some bone meal and some fresh water from Pam's Harvest Craft to make a slime ball. So it's not like you get a ton out of it either. You have to like, you know, spend a little bit of resources on it. But nonetheless, this should help out a lot because, I don't know, the slime seems really important to make progress in this pack right now. And I just feel like, you know, do we not have more bones? I just feel like that's something, a little bit of an oversight. Okay, that's a thing apparently. I'm not sure why, but we're just gonna ignore this for now. So to get the flour from BetterWithMods, I think you just put it into a mill. Right, wait, did my thing break again? No. Oh, I turned off the thing at the top. So one thing you need to keep in mind here is during a storm when it rains and stuff, these things can break, these gearboxes, so that's why I have a lever up there to shut it off in case it rains. But there is something we could do later to automate that, but we don't have access to it yet. But yeah, this should give us the flour, and I think... Yeah, we can also grind this down into more bone meal, so we get 6 out of it. We can even use mob heads, apparently. Uh-huh, and I added aquaculture. I'm still not sure about this one. Like I said, this is more like a dev version right now. There are some mods in here that may or may not be in here later on. But yeah, that's in there as well. So I'm gonna go get some of this stuff real quick. And actually, while that is grinding down stuff, the way we can get fresh water is you just put a bucket of water into your crafting grid. Now, once this is enough now. The rain collectors are actually going to be really important because this is your way of regenerating water, right? If water is finite, eventually you run out maybe, or you have to go further away to get some. But these rain collectors, I recommend building a bunch of these early on. Once they're completely full, you can actually fill a bucket with water, which is super good. So something to keep in mind. But yeah, we get, oh, we only get one fresh water. I thought we get four out of it. That was just with milk, right? The fresh water stuff. Yeah. There's also the sink. Wonder if that's worth investing. The sink I set up so that you need to feed the water. But I believe once you do give it a water bucket, you can actually grab multiple fresh waters out of it. Let me go make this. Let's make a sink, and also we need the, at least the cooking table. Okay, to do that we need leather. So we can actually use the cut leather, which gives you 2 per leather. And then you can use that to make a book, which is a little bit cheaper. Okay, there's that book. And then with this book we can make the cooking table, but we need some hardened clay. All right, let's see if this works. Let's put them over here, the sink and the cooking table. So if you open this, yeah, fresh water. Ah, shoot. I took it from my hand. Okay, hold on a second. So if we put this into the sink and let's put away the bucket, I should be able to grab water out of here, right? And is this just, no, it doesn't. Thought that would work. Alright, I just made a bunch of water, so it should be okay. So if you put this in here, bone meal and flour, yeah, it's making stuff now. So this should give us 9 slime blocks or bolts. Alright, let's start crafting our ice armor then. I don't think we have enough ice cubes even. I think I have to go back. Yeah, that's not gonna be enough. Whoops. Is it? Because we only get 3. We need 24 of these ingots for a full set. That's all we can afford. Oh well. It's okay, we can make some, and I'm gonna go get the rest. I think probably the pants and the chest plate are probably the ones we should start out with. But yeah, finally some slime balls and finally armor. Oops, can't put on that one because of my chest backpack. Finally armor that will keep us somewhat cool. It's already getting hot again, you can see the globe. But we are sort of, if you look at the season compass, looks like we're sort of going into fall right now. So probably didn't need that for too much longer, but definitely needed to to go into the nether. So that's awesome. So yeah, I'll just go get more ice off camera. Excuse me, a little bit of a hiccup again. Every time I record. I think it's the coffee. But yeah, I'm gonna go get that stuff off camera. And I'm glad we finally have some slime armor. And I also need to go back to finishing up this update, because some of you already have asked for it, which is awesome, but also I feel terrible. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye.